So this is my ever simple to-do list of web application that I have just deployed in interest of time on Azure App Services. And if I go ahead, and this is what the application does, it basically uses a SQL server behind the scene where I can create new tasks, and these tasks are persisted in Azure SQL behind the scene. Now, again, to start from a security perspective, the first step that you should do for your web application is to go through the whole security center experience for your web application. And if there are any recommendations which are for your web application, that will show up in the security center over here. If there are any security alerts or if there are any security recommendations, like you should be using example SSL or you should be using managed identity, those kind of alerts and recommendations show up here on Security Center. Now, starting up with the whole networking and VNet integration piece, let's look at the whole setup around VNet integration. So you basically navigate to the networking plate, and to configure VNet integration, you click on configure the VNet integration. As you can see, that my web application is already a part of VNet named PV3 VNet, and it is part of a subnet named app subnet. Now, once I go inside the app subnet, what I see here is that I am going to, this web application will securely connect to Azure SQL using service endpoints. And that's the reason that I am basically delegating the subnet to my web application, and the service that this will securely connect to is Microsoft SQL. Now, if I was to see the similar VNet settings from an Azure SQL perspective, basically, please understand that the networking settings for Azure SQL are applicable for the server and not for a database. So this is the database, by the way, that my application is using, 2DDB. What I am going to do here is I'm going to navigate to the underlying SQL server. And over here, when I go ahead and click on firewall and virtual networks, if you see, my SQL server is also pretty much part of the same virtual network, because if you remember, as I mentioned a few minutes back, both the database and the web application to make use of the regional VNet has to be in the same Azure region. And if you see, I'm explicitly saying that do not allow access to any Azure services and resources, because I want a secure connectivity over my VNet. And if you see, I can just go ahead and create a new task, and it just works. Now, just to again show you how things work, let me go ahead and disconnect my web application from this virtual network. And if I now refresh the page, the web application doesn't work because my web application is unable to connect to the underlying database. So let me go ahead and add the virtual network again. And as you can see, we are back to the similar configuration. And if I now go back and refresh my web application, it just works.